Okay, you guys, it's me again, Miss Nick, aka Nikki30263, and welcome back to my channel. As I stated in my drugstore haul video, I had another makeup haul that I also wanted to share with you guys. And as you can see in the title, it's a MAC makeup haul. This is my baggie full of things that I purchased at the CCO, which stands for the Cosmetic Company Outlet Store, and the MAC counter in the mall. And I think if you follow me on Twitter, I think I tweeted about it this past Saturday. We went to the CCO in Dawsonville, Georgia, and then we stopped by Lenox Mall to go to the MAC store, which they have two different department stores that I know of in Lenox Mall that has a MAC counter, and that's Macy's as well as Dillard's. I don't think it's Neiman Marcus. I think Neiman Marcus is at Phipps. But what I'm gonna do is share with you guys what I purchased at the CCO first. I'm gonna try to get all this in 12 minutes, cause that's all the time that I have. And for those of you that don't know, the CCO is basically an outlet store for higher-end makeup. They have Bobbi Brown in this particular CCO, MAC Cosmetics, Estee Lauder, and several other high-name makeup brands. But if you Google it, it should tell you pretty much what they carry at the CCO. So I was able to get some discounted MAC products at the CCO. And the first thing I got was this eyeshadow duo in Heat Element. It was $13.75 for this. And I'm not really sure how much, this is my first time opening, but I'm not really sure how much this costs regular price. What I'll do is put it in the video, or maybe at the description bar. But it's more so of a goldish and bronzy looking color. And I really liked it when I saw it, so I had to get it. Which is, it's kind of like this one that I also have. It's a Miracle, which I also purchased that one at a CCO too. Then I picked up Blunt, which is a powdered blush, for $13. And I got this because a lot of people say that it's good for contouring purposes. Which is kind of like a flesh tone brown. It's very matte. Then I also picked up another blush in Dirty Plum, which was also $13. And I'm not sure how this is going to look on me because it is purple. But I picked this up as well. I have a lot to share with you guys, so I'm not really gonna do a lot of swatches. So, and then I have a mineralized skin finish in Cheeky Bronze, which was $19. And I'm not sure how much this is for price. I think it's very expensive because my sister bought a Derella Mineralized Skin Finish at the MAC store and it was expensive. So if I use this, it'll probably be like for a bronzer because it has like gold shimmery flecks in it. And then I picked up these lashes. Not sure the number, but it has GA30 on the back of this. I'm not sure if that's correct, but they're kind of like the winged feathery eyelashes. I picked these up because I may wear these the night and I go out for my birthday. These are $8.50. Then I got GA70. I'm not sure if these numbers are correct. I'm gonna look these up, but these are half lashes. You just put them on the outside and go from there. It's not the full strip. And this one was $9.25. And that's what I picked up at the CCO. They also have lip glosses, lipsticks, foundations, concealers, the whole nine. But when I was there, I just wanted to basically pick up what caught my eye. I was looking for another blush that I picked up at the regular MAC store there, but they didn't have it, so I'll share that with you guys in a few minutes. I picked up some Studio Finish Concealer and NC50. And I used this already. I used it Sunday. And this concealer contains SPF 35. And I'll probably just use this to conceal my dark circle and cover up my unevenness right in here. And I don't have on foundation or any makeup. I'm gonna do a foundation routine video for you guys. And that's the concealer that I bought. Then I also purchased this blush that everybody has been raving about. And I tried it on and I love it. Raisin blush. Which is kind of like a reddish brown. It's very matte. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's a reddish brown color. It's not orangey, it's not too red, but it looks very, very good on my skin complexion, and I like it. No, I love it. Then I purchased Royal Flush pigment. I got this at the CCO. And this one was $13.75 at the CCO. Just basically a loose pigment. Ooh, it's pretty. And it's shimmery. You know, I see that. Very shimmery. I'm trying to pour it out. I tilted too far down so it won't spill. But I'm very anxious to use it. What I picked up at the MAC store and not the CCO. I left the paint part out of the CCO. Was Ramblin' Rose, which is a frost lipstick. And I saw this on display. It's kind of like a peachy lipstick. It has gold reflects in it. Swatch up for you guys. It's up here. You guys see that? Hopefully it's not orange. I Then I also picked up a satin lipstick, Viva Glam 2, which is a nude lipstick. And I wanted a nude lipstick. You guys can see it. Hopefully you can see it. But that's Viva Glam 2. And last but not least, I picked up a lip gloss in Revealing. And I wore this on Sunday. And I love that. I loved it. I will slash this on. I love it for you guys. It's very creamy. And it's a nude lipstick. I would suggest using a lip liner. Using a lip liner for this. It's very nude and it looks a lot better when my face is made up. But that's what I got this past Saturday at the CCO as well as the MAC store. And they're all MAC cosmetics. And I would suggest that, you know, if you have a CCO in your area, wherever you may be located, that you check it out. They're not going to carry the full line of MAC products. They're mainly discontinued products. Products that I guess no one was really purchasing. But they have pigments, shadows, lipsticks, lip glosses, foundations, concealers, the whole kit and caboodle. They just don't have a wider selection that you